Let's return to our top story now. 19 people have been killed following a bomb blast in the Nigerian capital, Abuja. It's the second such incident in the country in just over 2 weeks, leaving many to wonder why the government seems so powerless. Well, joining me now is Nigerian political commentator Kayode Ogundamisi. Kayode, is the Nigerian government powerless?
Obviously, yes. The Nigerian government is, they've proven that they can't handle the situation with Boko Haram. People talk about these 234 different figures kidnapped, but more than 4,000 to 6,000 people are reported to have been killed in the past 4 to 5 years. And every attempt by the government to use whatever method has failed. Professor Soyinka made a statement that leadership, there's a need to show leadership. But beyond this, I always say we need to tie it to the issue of corruption. Over $6 billion voted for security in the 2014 budget by the federal government. Our military keep complaining about their inability to have enough hardware to take the fight to the terrorists. Now, the right question that we should be asking the Nigerian government is, are we providing the military with enough support?
Well, the question that people are asking what now is, yeah, why isn't President Goodluck Jonathan speaking to the nation? He is the leader of the nation. He should tell us what's happening. Yeah. He seems reluctant to speak out publicly. Why is that?
I mean, President Goodluck Jonathan is not known to be proactive when it comes to managing crisis in the country. He's proven over time and time again that clear insensitivity to the plights of the people. And I take it down to the fact that it's political naivety on his part to think all you have to do is politicize the situation in the country. Boko Haram issue was treated like as if it was some mere political opponents trying to bring down his government. But he needs to situate this as we're dealing with international terrorism and take the battle in the sense that I've been saying we need to look at the borders between Niger and Cameroon. These guys are coming in from the border. And
well, I mean, Professor Soyinka in that earlier interview actually highlighted one of those points and said maybe Nigeria, the Nigerian leadership, missed a trick in tackling, in the way they tackled Boko Haram in its early stages. They should have gone hard, but they went with this softly, softly approach. Do you agree with him?
No, I completely disagree with Professor Soyinka. Every attempt by the Nigerian government to hit hard on the Boko Haram, we've paid dearly in terms of more people get killed. Each time the military come on here to say they've killed 300 Boko Haram members, we find Boko Haram issuing videos, you know, attacking military bases, releasing prisoners as it is. And we also look at, we have to look at the issue of human rights violation. If we say that Boko Haram do not have local support, we're actually deceiving ourselves. The fact that the military are committing enough, as much atrocities as Boko Haram. So the first thing we need to start doing is looking at the issue of human rights violation by our military, President Jonathan mobilizing the country, as Professor Soyinka did say.